नमस्कार, हूँ आदर्श छु। वेलकम टू आदर्श एजुकेशन सोसाइटी।
स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट स्टैंडर्ड 7 सब्जेक्ट सोशल साइंस चैप्टर नंबर 10 द अर्थ इंटरनल कंपोजिशन एंड लैंडफॉर्म्स। सो स्टूडेंट, इन फर्स्ट पार्ट वी लर्न दैट अ डेवलप्ड लाइफ ऑफ द सोलर सिस्टम इज ओनली ऑन द अर्थ प्लेनेट अर्थ and the interior of the earth is made up of several layers arranged on the top of another layer, the layer of an onion, and also the crust of planet Sima is mantle, and it is also extend up to the depth of 2900 km, and innermost layer of the earth is more, its radius is around 3500 km. And at the time of volcanic eruption, the hot magma of the interior of the earth flow out from the interior and spread on the surface of the earth. So the magma cools down and forms the rocks, which are called igneous rocks. Now today we learn second sedimentary rocks. So in the sedimentary rocks, we learn that rocks roll down, crack and hit each other and are broken down into small particles. Particles means small pieces. So rocks roll down, crack and hit means which are rocks are also rolled down, means going, moving and moving. Crack means broken and also hit means ek bichar ke ek dusre ke saath akhadana. So each other are broken down into small particles means when the rocks are also hitting each other, they are also make small pieces. These sedimentary melts and transported and deposited by winds, water, etc. So actually, sedimentary, the meaning of that sedimentary, so that one is rocks formed from the sand, stones and mud, etc., which are at the bottom of the lakes and river. यानी कि नदियों, झील आदि के नीचे, तालाब के नीचे या जमीन के नीचे जो जमा हुई रहती है, that one is known as a sedimentary rocks. Now these rocks are rolled down, cracks and hit each other and also melt. When they are hit and cracks, so it will definitely it will become in a small pieces. These sedimentary are transported and deposited by winds. So these sedimentary means small pieces. They meet each other and also transported. Then after some time, it is also transported in the deposited by and also transported and also deposited. Deposited means something left for a specific purpose. So that one deposited by wind or water. So they are also meet each other, collect each other by the wind or by water. Then those sediments are compressed. Compressed means something is made up, composition. So that one is compressed, means that one is to make it fill up with less space. If there are very many things are there, so we are push them and make it fill it properly and harder of form layers of rocks. These type of rocks are called sedimentary rocks. For example, sandstone is made from grains of sand. So here I also one example is given. That example is sandstone, patthar of stone of made of sand. Sand ka koi mitti ka reti ka koi patthar. So that one is an example. Sandstone is made up of grain of sand. These rocks may also contain fossils, means remains of plants, animals and other microorganisms that once lived on them. So actually microorganism, that one is sukshma jeev, which we can see only on microscope. So here they are explaining the fossils. Fossils means an animals or plants that lived thousands of years and also which are has turned into a rock. So these are the these rocks may also contain fossils of which are maybe they are animals or plants and other. Also we get to see all these. We have to use microscope that once lived on them. Now next one is metamorphic rocks. Metamorphic rocks means rocks that have been changed by heat or pressure. So rock which are also we can change by heat or some pressure we can move them. So igneous and sedimentary rocks can change into metamorphic rocks under great heat and pressure. For example, there is also one example of metamorphic rocks. Clay change into the slate and limestone into the marble. So here are two example is given. For example, clay, that one clay is changed into slate and also limestone into the marble. So in short, metamorphic rocks means igneous and sedimentary rocks can change into the metamorphic rocks under great heat and pressure. So they are very heat and pressure of that one. So then after it will also make metamorphic rocks. You will be surprised to know that one type of rocks change to another type under certain condition in a cycle manner. So here also we can see that one picture is given. That one is a one type of cycle. So we will also surprise to know that one type of rocks can also change in another type under certain condition in a cycle manner. So in a cycle manner, there is also upper side one picture is given rock cycle. So it means, so igneous rocks, then sedimentary rocks, then both together make metamorphic rocks, then it will also make in a magma. So you will be also surprised to know that one type of rock changes to another type under a certain condition. So to change for that, there is a one type of condition in a cycle manner. So it's moving and moving, but that one is number is going to same. First one igneous, then sedimentary, and third one is metamorphic rock, and then into the magma. This process of transformation of rocks is called rock cycle. So that one is known because all are rocks. So that's why its name is rock cycle. You have already learned that when the molten magma cools, when the molten magma become very cool, so that it solidifies, become igneous rock. So when it become cool, so then it again become the igneous rocks. These igneous rocks are broken down into small particles. Those are transported and deposited to form sedimentary rocks. So in the first, we learned that sedimentary rocks are also, when the igneous rocks are there and sometimes they are hit each other, so they are also made in a small part. That one is known as a particle, means small pieces of the rock. Then water and wind also take them out. So that one is known as a sedimentary rocks. So here I am explaining about the rock cycle. So first one, when magma become cool, then it will also become, after the cooling, it will become igneous rocks. When igneous rocks are ready, so they are also roll down, crack and hit each other, so it will become small pieces, means small particles. So then it is also sometimes transported and deposited by the wind or water. So then it will become sedimentary rocks. Then when the igneous and sedimentary rocks are subjected to heat and pressure, they change into the metamorphic rocks. So then they both are mixing and it will become the last one, metamorphic rocks. The metamorphic rocks which are still under extreme heat and pressure melt down to form molten magma. This molten magma cools down and solidified into igneous rocks. So here they are explaining one cycle. First one magma, it cooled down, then it will become igneous rocks. Igneous rocks are ready, then also they heat, crackle and heat each other and also make into small parts, and it is also transported by water or wind. Then it will become the sedimentary. So both igneous and sedimentary, both are also mixing and it will last become the metamorphic rocks. Then also metamorphic rocks are also when the igneous and sedimentary rocks are subjected to heat and pressure, so to change in the metamorphic rocks. And the metamorphic rocks which are still under the extreme and pressure, when it is melt down and it also become cools, then also it will become solidified. So then it will also become like an igneous rocks.
Thank you for joining us.